name is Joe, serving as net control for this session of the South Central Area Net. Net meets every Tuesday evening beginning at 8:30 p.m. local time on the Columbus Amateur Radio Club 2-meter repeater, operating on a frequency of 146.79 megahertz with a minus offset and a PL tone of 103.5 hertz. Net meets for the purpose of passing traffic, promoting good fellowship among amateur radio operators, and practicing net procedures. This is a directed net. Please direct all communications through net control. Your net control station this evening once again is KA9OPL, Kilo Alpha 9, Oscar Papa Lima. My name is Joe, located here in Columbus in Bartholomew County. This time, is there anyone holding any emergency, priority, or welfare traffic? If you have any emergency traffic during the net, please alert me with the words break break, and I will then assist you with your emergency. Do we have any routine traffic?
A9OPL, this is W9MDT, I do have routine traffic.
W9MDT, this is K9OPL. Recognize your routine traffic. Anyone else have anything to list? Traffic, Mike?
Yes, I have one piece of traffic for KD9PJO.
You want to call her directly to see if she's able to take her traffic, and if not, I'll take it.
Sure, I'll call. KD9PJO, this is W9MDT. How do you copy?
W9MDT, go ahead.
Please copy. Number 2054, routine, from K6HTN, Pasadena, California, date May 28th, going to your station, and I'll start the message now. Greetings by amateur radio, X-ray. Congrats on your new amateur radio license, X-ray. Ask Delivering Ham for more info about this message. 73, signed, Kate, K9HTN. End of message, no more.
I copied that. Thank you very much. Is that one of those, another radiogram?
Roger.
Okay, I'm clear. I will probably like to send a message back. It may take me a couple days. I'll email you about that, though. Thank you very much. KD9PJO is clear.
Ashley, and look forward to reading your email. K9OPL, this is W9MDT, back to net control.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Ashley. I actually wrote you down as well, Ashley. Got you checked in. Thank you both. Do we have any other traffic for the net this evening? We will then move on, and we'll begin taking short time check-ins here in just a moment. Remind everybody, please, when you check in, give your call sign using standard ITU phonetics, And give your name, also give your call sign in plain English. Call sign, stations are called by order of call sign suffix. However, for short-time check-ins, we do not break the alphabet down. I just take the short timers all at once, as orderly as possible, of course. If you do check in short time, I will not call you for comments later. So if you'd like to be short time, please begin now.
Kilo 9, Romeo, Mike, Romeo, repeat. K9RMR, Randall M. Roof, Titusville, Indiana. Short time. Good evening, Joe, and everybody else on the net.
Any other short time check-ins?
This is Kilo Alpha 9, Whiskey Bravo Golf. This is Sarah, KA9WBG. No traffic.
Whiskey Bravo 9, Sierra Mike Charlie, Don, Bartholomew County. No traffic. Good evening, everyone.
KA9WBG, wow, it's good to hear you, Sarah. Haven't heard you in a good while. Welcome aboard. WB9SMC, got you, Don. Any other short time? This is KA9OPL with the South Central Area Net. We'll move on to regular check-ins, and we will take stations with suffixes that begin with the letters Alpha through Hotel. Alpha through Hotel, please.
Stewart in Columbus, no traffic. Good evening, Joe.
Okay, good evening, KA9ENO. Stewart, got you. Any others? Alpha through Hotel. This is India through Romeo. India through Romeo, next.
Charlie 9, Romeo, Papa, X-Ray, KC9RPX, Jimmy, Elfville, Indiana, no traffic tonight.
Kilo Echo 4, Kilo Oscar, Quebec. The name is Buford, Columbus, Indiana, Bartholomew County.
Okay, we got KC9RPX and KE4KOQ. Good evening. Any others, India through Romeo? Rest of the alphabet, Sierra through Zulu, please. Sierra through Zulu.
N9TLF, November 9, Tango, Lima, Foxtrot.
November 9, Papa, United, Papa. Short time, no traffic.
And N9PUP. Asking for short time. Let's go with the entire alphabet. Anyone else who has not yet checked in, please call.
9OPL is Whiskey 9, Tango Charlie, Papa, Bartholomew County.
W9TCP. Any others? Alpha through Zulu. And I will go back to the top. And, of course, we do have our two that passed a message. And so we'll start with you two. Start with W9MDT. Mike, your turn for comments.
K9OPL, this is W9MDT. Good evening, Joe, and everybody on the net. Not really a whole lot going on here. Trying to stay safe and help my neighbor start putting up a new fence between us. You know what they say, good fences make good neighbors, but he's a pretty good guy anyway. But anyway, I do want to remind everybody that in 2 weeks, June 16th, we will be the SCI CSG group will be doing VE testing, once again, 6 p.m., 935 Rep Drive, Columbus, Indiana. That's the Columbus Township fire and rescue station number 221. And we do all classes from tech up to extra. So if you need an upgrade or you know somebody that's looking to get a tech license, send me an email. You can reach me at my call sign, W9MDT, at ARRL.net. But I wanted to get that in there because we are getting close here. We try to observe social distancing. I figure we can probably get maybe 8 in there. If you feel like you need to wear a mask, by all means, do so. We do have hand sanitizer and disinfectant wipes and all that kind of stuff. Clean the tables up before you get there. And that's about it. But otherwise, that's pretty much it for me, Joe. Looking forward to field day coming up in, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, something like that. Anyhow, I will turn it back to you, K9OPL. This is W9MDT, back to net control.
Okay, very good, Mike. Thanks for all of that, and thanks to the Laurel VE group for all of the work that's being done as far as the testing, and it's great getting to see some more new members to the ham community, and that's always appreciated and welcome. And one of those is next on the list, KD9PJO. Ashley, your comments.
Good evening, Joe, and everyone on the net. I don't really have a lot of comments this evening. I do want to say thank you for the VE testing group. I know that a lot of forums and stuff I read, people's had to wait days and even sometimes weeks to get their call sign in the database. And I know that both time Mike and I took our test, we got our call signs the very next day. So I know, really appreciate Mike, W9MDT, putting those in so quickly. I think that's excellent. I did want to make a comment to W9MDT that Mike, KD9OWO, would like to be added to the VE testing list to take his extra. I'm still studying for my general. I'm not sure yet if I'm going to get it in 2 weeks or not, but I'll definitely let you know. But anyways, I hope everyone has a wonderful week, and I'll send it back to you. This is KD9PJO.
Hey, thank you, Ashley, and good, very good. Thanks for being there as usual, and always appreciate your comments and have a good evening. Let's see, I'm looking past all the short timers. And we move on to KA9ENO. Stuart, your turn.
Good evening, Joe, and to everybody on the net tonight. Didn't do a whole lot around here today. Went and got another load of mulch. I've just got a little bit left to do, and I'll be done. Actually, got an excess amount now, so I'm going to end up taking that down to my parents' house. My dad's also a ham in Shoals, Indiana, so I'm going to be headed down that way tomorrow to do a little bit of power washing and use up some of this mulch, and I've been helping them with a project here the last week or so. So I'll be on the road most of the day tomorrow, but definitely enjoying this nice warm weather. I enjoy this a lot better than the cold weather. So with that, Joe, I'm going to pass it back over to you. This is KA9ENO, back to net control.
Okay, very good, Stuart. I'm with you on the warmer weather. It always welcome, and it also accomplishes something else, which is helps to deflect the COVID-19 stuff. At least that's what I've been given to understand, and it kind of makes sense. And we're getting up into that good range, the summer temperature range now, without getting into the real hot temperatures, but we're getting, we're certainly getting warmer. Let's see, next I got KC9RPX. Jimmy, your turn for comments. Went short time, he didn't say, but KC9RPX, I'll give you another call if you have any comments. Then we'll move on to KE4KOQ, Buford. Good evening. Good to hear you in there.
Ah, good evening to you. This is KE4KOQ. Not much going on around here. But anyway, I sit around here all the day and waited for my caregiver, but she didn't show up. So guess I'll have to wait another day or two. But anyway, I don't know. Me and hot weather don't get along too well. But looks like it's here to stay for a while. Of course, got some rain coming in, so that'll be something. And it's good to hear the new ones out there tonight. And, well, it's good to hear everybody out there tonight. But anyway, got a short anecdote, Joe. Last night I had a most unusual dream. I dreamed that I crossed a dog with a cantaloupe. So I'm not going to ask you to tell me what I got. I got a melancholy baby. That's all I have from this end. KE4KOQ, back to net. Everyone have a good evening and a good rest of the week.
All right, Buford. You're always always good for a laugh, and can always count on you for something. Good to hear you in there this evening, and thanks for being there. Let's see, N9TLF, Paul, your turn.
Good evening, Joe, N9TLF here. I don't know, we may have to send the cops over to Buford's house for an illegal joke. I'm not sure if that one's allowed or not, but anyway, everything's going pretty good over here. We're enjoying the nice weather, too, except it's making the grass go like crazy, so we have to keep mowing it, but... And we'll say congratulations to Ashley on your new license. I wasn't sure who you were, so I Googled your call sign, and you just popped right up. So you'll be glad to know you're famous now on the Internet. So we'll turn it back to Net Control, N9TLF.
All right, very good. And it was good to hear your better half out there. Hello, Sarah. Even if you did go short time, at least you came in. So that's good news. Now that there's more representation from the female population, maybe Sarah will get on more often. I don't know. Nonetheless, it's good to have everybody here. And let's see. PUP was short time. We move on to W9TCP. Jason, your turn.
Greetings to Joe and the Net. This is W9TCP. I was able to make it home and get on my other radio, so I hope this is coming through clear. The only thing I had is to see if there's anyone that wanted to stay after. I need to play with this and figure out how to transmit at a lower wattage to practice being a good neighbor on here and not be sending it 50 or 60 watts, whatever this is, and try to see if I can step it down to 1 watt and still come through. So with that, if there's anyone that wants to volunteer when the net's over, I'd appreciate it. This is W9TCP, back to net control.
Alright, very good. Well, you're definitely loud and clear now, and yeah, I should be able to stick around for a couple minutes afterwards and see if we can get that thing the way you want it. Sounds very good. So, good to hear you in there. That is the bottom of the current list. So, this is KA9OPL, and I'll stand by with the South Central Area Net. Do we have any additional check-ins, please?
Whiskey Niner, Romeo, Whiskey Romeo, W9RWR, Rick in Bartholomew County.
And I believe there was a double there, and I didn't get the double. So if there was another station checking in, please come again.
N9CJT, good evening, Joe.
Alrighty, N9CJT, got you, Noel. Let me make one more call to see if we have anyone else, and then we'll give you guys a chance to give comments. Any other stations would like to check in?
K9RMR, I checked in short time. I didn't know if you got me.
I did, and I thought I called you, but yep, I've got you written down. So, let's see. One more call. Anyone else? Hey, let's go back to W9RWR. Rick, good evening. I mean, yeah, I guess you're right. Okay, W9RWR. Go ahead, Rick.
Joe, and the net. Just came up to the radio room a little late. Caught the tail end of the net and wanted to make sure I got on the log. Had internet installed today, so I stayed home an extra day, but it's back to work. We're back on a normal schedule now, so I just have to get used to it again. Hi. Hope everybody's well and safe and healthy, and have a great week. Always good to hear your voice, Joe. W9RWR, back to net control.
I don't know if I didn't transmit that last time around. If I didn't, thanks for being there, Rick, and always good to hear you. Probably won't hear you as much now that you're going back to the regular routine. N9CJT, your turn, Noel.
Well, good evening, Joe, and the net. And I think I must have slept through the early part of the net because all of a sudden, there was the net halfway through or more. I did hear Ashley, and that was the first station I heard, so that might give you an idea as to how many I missed. But anyway, I was going to pull the net this evening, and I guess that's not going to happen. But I would be curious to know if there's anyone on frequency still listening that would not be willing to attend an in-person club meeting next Thursday night. So I'll turn it back to you, Joe, and you can see if there's a way to get some answers. N9CJT, back to net.
Okay, N9CJT, thank you, Noel. This is K9OPL, and I, for one, would be willing. I'll have to range that. I haven't been actually still working from home since we're not going back into the office yet. I would if they were ready to go that way, but I for one will be willing. Let's do it as you said, Noel, which is anyone who would not be willing, if you're still listening on frequency, I'll stand by right now for any stations who want to register the fact that they would not be interested in an in-person club meeting next week. This is KA9OPL. I will stand by.
KA9OPL, this is W9TCP. I guess I would have the question of what size room would we be in, and you know, how many would it be able to seat, and how many would be there?
Okay. Noel, can you field that question?
sure can. I have no clue how many will show up, but the room is the India room, which I think Jason is familiar with at St. Peter's. N9CJT, back to net.
Did that give you an answer?
K9OPL, W9TCP, yes. I'm quite familiar with that room, and based off of what we normally have in attendance, I'd be comfortable attending, so I would not be on the will not attend list, if that makes sense. Back to net.
Okay, very good, thank you, and well, good. So we got some more information that way, and presumably it's a reasonably sized room, so we can appropriately distance as however people feel comfortable. Any others who would like to say no? If you're okay with it, you don't have to comment unless you so choose. But if you'd like to say no, I don't want to do that. If you're still listening, please call. I don't hear anyone else at the moment. This is K9OPL. I'll stand by one more time. Anyone else who'd like to check into the net while we're still here? We will call this net officially complete at 9:02 p.m. Eastern Time. And wish everybody a good evening. 73s, K9OPL will be clear, and I'll stand by. I need to write a few things down, and then Jason, or if anyone else wants to call you, see if we can get your radio adjusted. This is K9OPL. Good evening, all 73s, and we'll look forward to doing this again next week.
N9CJT with a question for Jason. Did you want to do this on this frequency, or were you wanting to go simplex somewhere?
N9CJT, W9TCP. Yeah, I am. I would rather do it on here. I'm trying to figure out, I've got a high, medium, and low power, and I want to see where I need to be set to for this repeater, so I'm still coming in full quieting, but not broadcasting any more power than what I need to.
Okay, well, for my curiosity, what is the rig? What are high, medium, and low, and what antenna are you using?
This is a ICOM, and I can't remember the model number off the top of my head. Actually, if I think it's K9RWR is still on here. He could probably tell you quicker than me. I think a 2700. And I believe the power settings are 50, 25, and 1, or 15, 25, and 5. I've got a SWR meter here that I'm going to monitor, and I can tell that I'm just shy of 50 right now. And this is going to a homemade J-pole at the edge of my roof.
How high up?
See, the top of my roof is probably going to be about 30 feet, so we're getting close to 40 feet by the time you add the mast and everything.
Okay. Well, I suspect you could go to low power, whatever that is, and still be into the repeater solid. I could be wrong, though, so I'll stand by, and I guess we'll find out. W9TCP and the group, N9CJT.
N9CJT, this is W9TCP, and I am on low power, which appears to be 5 watts. Am I coming through just as well?
I can't tell the difference. You're still pegging the meter here, N9CJT. Of course, the repeater is pegging the meter, but no, I hear no difference. You are full quieting into the machine, N9CJT. What do you think, Joe?
Same here. No background noise or anything. So, of course, I was expecting that's the way it would be with the antenna being high up enough. So, all good as far as I'm concerned. Back to you, Jason.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Yeah, if I can use 1/10 the power, I think it's always better to do so. So, glad to finally have a real decent radio here. I need to sit down and program a bunch of other frequencies into it, but that's always a good part of the fun, isn't it? This is W9TCP, back to net.
K9OPL, I'll give it back to you, Noel, in a minute. And by the way, I also could still hear you on input. I could hear a little bit of background noise on input, but still could hear you clearly. Over to you, Noel.
Reverse, but I will certainly believe what Joe says. He's quite a bit further away from you than I am. Just to give you an idea about how sensitive the repeater is, though, I think you probably know that horizontal antenna is a 20 dB disconnect from a vertical antenna. A few days ago, I checked into, I think it was one of those Saturday morning nets, and you're going to laugh, but I grabbed the wrong coax, hooked it to the radio. I was transmitting 1 watt from the radio into a 272-foot horizontal loop antenna that's resonant at 3580. So, wrong frequency, wrong antenna, wrong polarization, and apparently I was full quieting into the repeater the whole time and nobody knew it until I realized what antenna I was unplugging as the storm approached. N9CJT, back to you, Jason.
Wow, that's pretty sensitive, although I think you're quite a bit closer to the repeater than I. I know from my handheld, I'm in and out as I walk through the buildings in this neighborhood at probably something that's around 4 watts, and I definitely can't transmit out of my basement where I'm at now with that. But I can reach the 70-centimeter repeater over on this side of town, even from my basement, and it's full quieting. So it's location makes a bit of difference, too. Back to you, this is W9TCP.
Location, location, location. Yeah, I'm probably 2 miles closer if you consider east and west only. And I'm 2 miles further if you take north and south into account. But yeah, I am a little closer to the repeater. That still doesn't explain how that antenna was able to get that 1 watt signal. Well, live and learn. It's a fun hobby. Do you have programming software for that rig, or are you going to be programming it manually?
I did program this frequency in manually, which was a million times easier than the BTEC or Baofeng or the various other little cheap radios I've used. They're a nightmare to program, and this was far more logical, and I'd be comfortable if someone gave me the details, entering it into a frequency without having too much trouble. But that said, I did find on ICOM's website, they have both PC and Mac software, and I was actually going to try the Mac for the first time, but I don't have the right cable for it, so I need to download the Windows version and give that a shot.
Looking around here somewhere, I've got a list of various different locations, frequencies, and PL tones that I could share with you if I can find it. So give me another minute or two to dig, and go ahead and chat with Joe at 9CJT.
Okay, Jason, so is that a dual band radio, 2 meters, 70 centimeter?
Yes, that's correct.
We're still looking. I know I've got it, though, so would you want me, if I succeed in finding it here in a minute, would you want me to read stuff over the air, or scan it in and email it to you, or what's your pleasure?
If you don't mind scanning it in and emailing it, I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, well, then I won't tie up the frequency any further, and other than I'll give you a call to let you know on this frequency when I do succeed in finding it and getting it emailed. Is that all right?
That'll work for me. Thank you. W9TCP.
Okie doke. N9CJT clear the frequency. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening, all K9OPL.
Ah, yeah, thanks, Joe. I definitely will do. He finally made it back to Indiana, so I got to see him this past weekend. I'm sure I'll be out there next weekend. I'll tell him you said hi. Thank you. This is W9TCP.
All right, K9OPL. 73 is all.
W9MDT, KD9PJO.
W9PJO, this is W9MDT.
Hi, Mike. I just wanted to confirm, did you hear what I said on the net about adding KD9OWO to the testing list?
Sure did, and I added him to the roster. For that session, not to put any more pressure on him than he's already got, but the test or the questions will change in July. So this for the extra. So this will be the last session we use this version of the test. They rotate the question pool every 3 years. Last year we changed general. Year before last we changed technician, and then this year is extra. So it'll be a couple of years. No, we'll skip a year and then we'll change technician again. So like I said, they'll change the question pool. All that really means is instead of if A and B are C, you know, the next time it may be worded differently. C is equal to A and B instead. Of course, the physics and the electronics and all that stuff, that doesn't change, but the theory behind it, but the way the questions are formed changes, so that makes it a little bit tougher. Just thought I'd throw that in there.
Okay, thank you for that. I think he was aware of that. That's why he's been studying pretty hard, because he had started studying for it, then he had heard that they were going to change. So he was happy to hear that you guys were doing testing before the end of the month. So he has been studying hard for that. But I just wanted to make sure, since he wasn't able to be here for the net tonight, that I got him on the list. And like I said, I'm studying for my general. I don't want to be on the list yet, because I'm not sure if I'm going to have it down by then, but you never know. So I'll definitely be getting a hold of you if I want to be at it, but right now I'm not sure. So, anyways, thank you, and I definitely will be emailing you back about the radiogram, and I hope you have a good evening. This is KD9PJO, and I'll be clear.
Ashley, I think you've become a rock star. You're getting all these radiograms and stuff. Your name appears on the internet now. Again, and in a good way. So that's a good thing. congratulations again, and we'll be talking to you further on down the log. KD9JPO. No, PJO. Pardon me. This is W9MDT, and I'm clear.
because I don't think Mike got any radiograms, so I've been totally rubbing it in that I have been, so I just think that's funny you said that. Anyways, but I am enjoying my time that I get on the radio, and I'm enjoying learning new things. So thank you again, and this will be my final KD9PJO.
What it's all about. Enjoy it, have fun. And yeah, rub it into Mike a little bit that he didn't get any. I think there are so few, and pardon me if I sound sexist, but there are so few females on